Every time I feel how life goes by, I recall the scene.
This is the third time here. I mean, we've got to keep meeting like this. I know you zipped in, and I suppose it's a kind. Well, will you be seeing Arnie? Because it's a very unusual arrangement you've got. Your sort of marriage arrangement. Is that right that he lives a lot of the time in the UK and you live in the USA?
Well, his profession, his career makes it. His work works easier from here, from London, and my career, of course, works. Well, either place, here or in America, but I'm being American. My children are brought up over there and they're in school. It's hard for us to be together all the time. But there's a special freedom in a relationship that is separate like that, because what happens is we both keep our individuality. It's difficult mostly for the children. But for me, I think every time we come together, it's very romantic, and it's like renewed. There's some renewing time there.
Honeymoon time, isn't
it? Yeah, it's like new each time. Yeah. It's special. So right now, it's understandable, but I think in the long run, it's difficult for children that both parents need to. Or it's nice that they're both there, don't you think? Yeah. Somebody tell her to get over there. I might have to move over here.
Yeah. I think they'd like that. Did you enjoy writing the book, Secrets of a Sparrow? That's an interesting title, Secrets of a Sparrow. How'd you come up with that?
Well, Sparrow, my mother used to call me a sparrow. And then there was this song that she loved, an old spiritual called His Eye Is on a Sparrow. And in fact, when she passed away, we sang it for her at her funeral. But it is a very moving spiritual. And it's a song that sounds as if you're being protected somehow. And Secrets of a Sparrow is just that. It's some of the secrets, some of the things that has happened in my life that I've never really talked about. And I use writing the book like therapy in a sense, you know, trying to find out why you do what you do and how is this wonderful life possible, is what makes it so, you know, I've had a very special, blessed life.
Mm. But you've had a fun life too, haven't you?
Yes, goodness, I'm telling you.
That's the one thing, if I'm honest, that I missed in the story. The one thing that didn't seem to be was humor, that I know you laugh and you like comics and you go to parties. If you were throwing a party tomorrow, who would you invite? I mean, who do you think would be the most fun at a party? Your friends.
I've been really thinking about this because next year I have my 50th birthday.
What?
Give this really, really big birthday party, and then I thought, maybe I'll just give a small intimate party with the people that I love, my friends, family, and so on.
Music. You've had this little knack over the years, Diana, of remaining contemporary and yet not giving up the quality of the music. Do you take a long time to decide what kind of single you're going to issue?
I love the romantic ballads, and I've been lucky over the years to really find some wonderful ones, Endless Love and When You Tell Me That You Love Me and If We Hold On Together, and these two, which I think are tremendous. I found this song, Best Years of My Life and Your Love, which I'm going to do for you today. Our new single here in the UK is called Your Love, but I found this song and I save it. I like wait for the next recording sessions, and I won't let anybody know what the song is because I don't want someone else to record it before I do. But to find a special song,
it's like
a gift.
Isn't it?
And a lot of times you attract these, the really good songs, and you have to hold on to.
And you're going to sing the new song for us now?
I'm going to, yes.
New song is called Your Love.
Your Love.
And we're glad you stopped off before your shopping and see that husband.
Yes, I see him all the time, you know. More than people think. I think we talk about our living arrangement, but we spend a lot of time.
I must tell you one true little story. I did a talk show in this very studio many years ago, and the host was a man called Eamon Andrews, sadly no longer with us. And we had an actress called Susan Hampshire, and she lived in England, and her husband lived in Paris. And they were talking about this on the air, and she only saw him at weekends, she said. And Eamon Andrews turned to me and said, would that kind of arrangement suit you? And I said, well, if her husband doesn't mind, I don't. Anyway, we're delighted you're here and you're going to sing this song for us. Ladies and gentlemen, Diana Ross.
Thank you.
Start to wonder if there's one thing that means more than others I have known. And suddenly it's clear to me, without your love, where would I be? Your love. It's kept me growing. what time may bring, but through the highs and lows of it, I'll know that there's one thing of which I'm sure, the one thing.
Thank you.